right. I'm back. So I'm headed on an estimate right now. I'm on self-steering as of right now. And I got a 19-mile drive, 23 minutes of traveling time ahead of me, right? And heading to an estimate, letting my Tesla drive me, because that's how we roll when you buy a Tesla. Now, I don't really want to... I got to get off the Northern State Parkway in 18 miles. Off to the Northern State Parkway in 18 miles. I don't want to really drive. Right now, it's just self-steering. If I hit the blinker and want to get into my left-hand lane, which I just did, the car automatically goes into the left-hand lane, right? That's self-steering. You know, nothing too crazy. But I can hit my blinker again right here, and it goes into the middle lane, right? Which is pretty cool. I got a car behind me that was just kind of coming into this lane. I was driving a little aggressively, so I'm going to speed up a little bit. But anyway, so now let's say I just want to chill. I just want to sit back, relax, and enjoy the drive. I want to get off this exit, but I don't want to really do anything. I'm going to hit this button, navigate on autopilot. And right now, for those who want to stick around and watch the video and see what else happens throughout the drive, I'm going to show you how in 23 minutes, 19 miles, this car will get off the exit. And right now, it's on navigate on autopilot, meaning, so that's taking me off the exits. I already said that. But if there's a car in front of me that's going slow, my car wants to pass it because it's not keeping to 63 miles per hour. So these cars in front of me that I'm coming up on, and now there's a little bit of traffic. There's a lot of cars in the world. It's 4:41 p.m. on a Saturday in New York, Long Island, driving on the LIE as of right now. So there's a lot of cars on the road. And my car is definitely without a shadow. Look, it's stopping pretty aggressively because I'm coming to traffic. I just went from 63 miles to 24 miles per hour. So that's it. So that's just basically my car. I'm sitting in traffic. I don't know if you guys want to wait, but my car is just patiently driving, which is what I love about this car. I don't have to do anything. I'm a passenger in my own car. I'm just chilling, and I like to look at other people when they're driving. It's kind of like a game I play because I want to see if they're looking at me. Sometimes, a lot of times, they actually are. And then if I'm videotaping, they look at me with disgust in their eyes. But at the end of the day, I own a Tesla and you own a Hyundai Elantra or a Honda Civic or a BMW and or a Nissan Altima. I'm just pointing out cars around me. Or a Subaru, which is right in front of me. A Dodge Durango. And your cars don't have this option. So don't be mad at me. So right now my car is trying to get into the left-hand lane on its own. I didn't do anything. I didn't tell it to go into its left-hand lane. Why? Because that is the faster lane of out of the three. So my car wants to get in and is showing that. And I'm not going to do anything here. It's showing that it wants to get in. And now it just aggressively kind of went into the spot. But the car behind me seen the blinker and allowed me to go in. I didn't do anything. It took me into the left-hand lane. Why? Because it's the quicker lane. Pretty cool. This is the reason why you guys stick around, so you can see stuff like this. Let's say there was a pretty dope, I'm trying to think of things that, let's say there's a pretty dope car that I like that's driving past me. Ferrari, Lamborghini, anything pretty fresh. I don't know, maybe that Dodge, you know, that pickup truck, that white pickup truck was pretty fresh. I can honk the horn right now, and I'll save a clip to my SIM card, or I can hit this button right here, which is basically the camera with the record button on, because the car is always recording, and I hit that, and it says, save the dash cam footage. So what is that? That goes straight to my USB, and it's saving a video, about a 6-minute video of my drive up until that point, and about a minute or so past. And it just gives you your drive, the car that you were driving next to. It basically just saved the video clip of about 10 minutes, which is pretty cool, right? So if something happened about 2 minutes ago and I honked the horn 3 minutes later, I would still have it on my clip because it records. It gives you a video clip of about like 10 minutes back or like 8 minutes back. It's pretty cool. I don't want to like shine my camera in people's faces while I'm driving, right? I'm making this video. But as I'm driving, I'm looking around and I'm paying attention. My hand is like right here, lightly on the steering wheel, right off my knee. The car is driving itself. I'm paying attention to the drive. I'm not really looking at the camera right now, so don't think I'm just, oh, I'm looking at the camera. Here's a pretty cool thing, right? Watch this. Watch the cars. Watch the wheel spinning. How cool is that? And I'm passing that car on the side right now. So it has, it shows me passing it. And look at the wheel spinning. And then it goes back. It only stays like that for about, I think, 10 seconds. I don't even know. I don't know, count it. But how fucking fresh is that? Oh, excuse my language. I didn't mean that. How fresh is that? And it just shows the car and then it goes back. Maybe it's 5 seconds. I didn't count. Somebody out there's gonna check the video cam. Minutes, seconds. But, all right, that's one of the coolest features I like. I can see who's behind me. Zoom in, top view. That's pretty cool, man. I love that. I really do. Good job, Elon. A lot of cool features in this car. A couple things I wish that they had. I wish that when I was at a charging dock, or when I'm at a charging dock and I can play video games and I can play like chess with friends, I wish that I could like throw out a competition to my neighboring Tesla owner next to me in the supercharging station. That sounded pretty stupid, so let me say it again. I wish that when I'm supercharging and there's a neighboring car that's supercharging as well, another Tesla, I can like send them a message and say, hey, you want to play chess? Because it has chess. Hey, you want to play Mario Kart or the Tesla driving game? You know, that would be pretty cool. And have like a little fun game, a little competition while I'm there. How cool would that be? Probably soon to come. Elon, get on it. But so I got 13 miles. I'm in the left-hand lane. I'm finally moving now. Speed limit is 55. I'm doing 63. My car is set for 63. I'm doing 62. So you have, this is how fast I'm driving. This is what my car is set for, and that's the speed limit. If I wanted to drive a little faster, I'm gonna hit this right here. I'm gonna scroll up, hit the scroll button, and scroll up. And look what happens. Now I'm at 72 miles per hour. But this car in front of me is only doing 66 because I have the car set for 3 car lengths away from the car in front of you. So this car will stay or maintain its pace between that, behind that car. And if it notices that the middle lane is faster, it will get into the middle lane because it's set up on Navigate on Autopilot. It's pretty cool. This is the quick lane. This is the fast lane. So I'm pretty sure the car will stay here. It has nowhere to go. I don't think it will. Maybe it will. Let me see. I'm going to pick it up a little bit to like 80 miles per hour. I'm going to see if this car will get into the right-hand lane. I know it gets into the left-hand lane for sure, but I don't know if, because the left-hand lane is the passing lane, I don't know if this car will get into the right-hand lane to pass this car in front, which as of right now, it hasn't done it, right? I have my speed control set for 84, 85. If I was in the middle lane, 100% this car would get into the left-hand lane and pass. So now I can easily take control of this car. All I have to do is touch the steering wheel, bring it to the side, and pass that car in front of me very easily. But I'm in no rush. I'm patiently driving. The car is driving itself. It's going to get off that exit when it needs to. And that's that. Go buy yourself a Tesla. And if you do, use my referral code. Stop it. Definitely use my referral code. Please. Hit me up, send me a message, say, hey, thinking about a Tesla, what's your referral code? I'll give it to you. Simple. You can order your car right online. What do I get? I get 1,000 free supercharging miles. So now the car is getting into its right-hand lane. Why? I have no clue. You know, I had it set for 84 miles per hour. Now I'm thinking, this is what's going to happen, guys. Oh, it's getting into its right-hand lane. This car is getting into its right-hand lane because it wants to pass this car. Definitely wants to pass this car. Now I'm picking up. I got my shit set for 84 miles per hour. Now
back into its middle lane.
I'm going to slow it down a little bit because I'm going pretty fast. 73. I have it set for 84. Take it down soon. But I'm still going to be doing 73, 74, right? I'm going to take it down to 76 miles per hour. That's it. I'll pace this car right here. As long as this car stays around the speed, my car will stay right behind it. I'll just pace it the whole time. Just driving, guys. I'm not doing anything. Just paying attention. Hand on the steering wheel right here, right off my knee. Just chilling. Not just like lightly touching it. And that's it. Again, it's 4:50 p.m. Saturday. This is the Long Island Expressway. I'm heading to the Northern State Parkway. And that's how we're rolling. This is like a live footage video. I'm not going to cut it or edit it. Right now the car is asking me to slightly, it says apply slight turning force to steering wheel. So I just take my hand, go a little something like that, and that's it. What I did was I just went a little too much and I took it off of self-steering. That's what happens, or self-driving. So if I take, if I put a little too much pressure to the right, see how I just took it off. That's it, a little pressure on the steering wheel and it takes it off of self-steering. I just flick this lever down twice. And that's it. Back on navigate on autopilot. Take me to my destination. So you got to see the video footage. The music is pretty fresh. But, you know. And the sound system is pretty good as well. All about that Tupac. Slowing down hard. hardcore. Look at that. And it did. Why? Because it slowed down hardcore. Now there's a car coming up on my left hand side, so it's not going to get over. But it wants to. And here we go. After this car passes, there's no one behind me. There's no one behind me. And the car gets right over. How cool is that? How cool is that? And now it's in the fast lane. To pass the slower car, you know, and that's just only because I put the speed up. I could have just paced the car, which is fine with me. I'm not in a rush. Again, I'm just trying to show you guys what Tesla Navigate on Autopilot is all about. Yeah, it's a long video, whatever, it's fun. Listen to some music. You got a little Snoop Dogg. How cool is the navigation? I mean, look, I could zoom in. I see people's pools as I drive. It's insane. You see the school. There's a pool right there. You see all the pools? I mean, it's insane. It's like Google Maps. It's what it is. It is basically Google Maps. And you see the name, Eddie Edge. Pretty fresh. That's how we roll. That's my name, Eddie Edge. Don't forget it. And here we are getting into the middle lane right now. Why? I don't know. I just wanted to get into the middle lane. That's it. Maybe it thinks it's going to be going faster than that, than the left lane. I don't know. The car wanted to get into its middle lane. It has a mind of its own. It is speeding up, and it is pacing that universe truck in front of us. That's it. So now, in 2.2 miles, 2.2, I'll be getting off. You guys still with me? I'm wondering who watches these videos full all the way. If I'm that entertaining or not, or if, you know, watching my Tesla drive is that entertaining. If it is, I mean, it's pretty cool. I make it for you. I'll tell you that much. The page is taking off. People, Tesla's hot. It's a hot topic. People love it. And I love it. I love my car. It's the only reason why I make these videos. I was never a video guy. I never made these videos for anything that I've ever owned before. But I owned a Tesla, and I got a Tesla December 19th, 2019. This is a 2020 Model 3. Full self-driving, long-range package. I have 40,000 miles on this car. So here, I'll show you the proof. 39,609 miles. I've had this car for a year and 1 month. I've got December 19th, 2019 is when I brought it home. Do the math. Today is, it's the 30th. Yes, the phone's not connected. Sorry, that's because I'm making the video and I took the Bluetooth off. But today's the 30th, right? Of January. It's January 30th, just to be clear. But anyway, that's that. So, I mean, you see I do a lot of driving. 39,609 miles. A lot of driving. So in 0.2 miles, this car is taking me. I'm going to show you the steering wheel. I'm going to show you everything that's going on. I'm not touching anything. Hands over here. And in 0.2 miles, 0.1 miles, this car is going to get off the Northern State Parkway, which is an aggressive turn right here. It's going. It's driving pretty aggressively, and it doesn't know exactly where to go because the lines are really wide. Now it's going to close off, and now I have to make this left-hand turn here. That's it. So now basically the car here, from this point on, it's on cruise control. But it won't make this hard left-hand turn, not yet. I don't have beta. Some people do, beta is out. But eventually this car will be able to make this left-hand turn and with no problem. Supposedly. It's coming soon. Some people have it. Who knows? Right now it's telling me that I'm stopped for a traffic light. That's the little black note on the bottom. I'm making a left on Deer Park Road. And the car is at my feet are here. I'm not doing any gassing or braking. All I'm doing is just steering right now. And I'm steering the car to where I have to go. Coming to another red light. There's nowhere to go. But I'm just steering. That's all I'm doing. Right here, at this point here, I can put it into self-steering. So I'm going to click this down twice. Now I got the two blue lines. Now my car is going to stay in this lane. So 0.1 miles, I have to make a right on Talesman Drive. This car is going to move now. And it's steering. I don't have to steer anymore because I have the white lines on the street and it still self-steers. 300 feet, I'm going to be making a right. This is what I'm doing. I'm doing this. I took control and now I'm in the neighborhood that I have my estimate. So over and out. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. On my way to the house, I still got cruise control. Wow, I'll show you another cool thing. See if I come up to a stop sign. Right now I'm looking for a stop sign before I go. This will be the last point of the video. I'm in cruise control. My car is driving. Here's my feet. I'm not doing any gas or braking. Try to speed it up just a little bit, just to get to where I'm going. So now I got it at 30 miles per hour. I'm doing 29 miles per hour. I'm just driving through the streets, right? When my car sees this stop sign, here's a good one. Look, and it's showing the stop sign. This car will stop. I'm not doing anything. The car is going to stop at the stop sign. It's going to show the white line, and it stops. For me to keep going now, all I have to do, I have two options. I can click this down once, or I can hit the gas pedal. I like to click this down. I click the driving shaft down, and it drives. And it'll take me to the next stop sign. It's going to bring me back up to 30 miles per hour. It doesn't look like this neighborhood has many stop signs, I got to be honest. So I don't know if I'm coming up to another one anytime soon. Heading up a hill is a nice little pretty neighborhood. I'm looking forward to this estimate that I'm going on right now. I'm a contractor, FYI, on Long Island. I build houses. I bought myself a Tesla, and I love it. And I'm making stupid YouTube videos. Here's another stop sign. Stops, on its own. I didn't do anything. The car stops. Again, what do? Last time I clicked the lever, this time I'm going to hit the gas. Put my foot here, hit the gas a little bit, little nudge. That's it, and it goes. Now, I came off of self-steering because there's no lines in the road. If these side streets had lines, I would be able to self-steer no problem. But anyway, that's my estimate. I'm on my way. I'm on my way to my estimate. That's my video. And I hope you guys loved it. Enjoy. Write, comment, subscribe, follow, do it all. Thanks, bud. Thank you. Thank you, people. I'm talking to you like you're my customers. Thanks, bud. Whatever. I'm a loser making YouTube videos of my Tesla. Whatever.